Cyber charter reform. There's a bill 1422 I'm a co-sponsor of. Cyber charters pull out of school districts an equal a tuition every time a student leaves a brick and mortar public school and goes to cyber charter. They get paid just like they're in a bricks and mortar school, even though they don't have the bricks and mortar, they don't have the bus transportation, they don't have a lot of the expenses. They get the same dollars that gets paid by our taxpayers. You do. We write that check out of the school districts to that charter. In addition to that, the way special education funding works, they take an average of whatever the school district spends and says that you get that too if you have someone who has like a speech impediment or some therapy or something, some IEP, which is a special education. Well, what's happened is in a public school like this, there's different levels you pay the cost. So if someone has speech therapy, it might cost $2,000 or $3,000 of service support. Someone who's in a wheelchair, who has special life skills requirements, it might be $200,000 in cost for that student. So it, because we are required to pay for any student that comes to our school, which is great. The charters don't have to take any of those kids. They only take kids that are on the lower end of the spectrum, but they get paid like the average. So what happens is the average for here is about $30,000 in tuition for a kid with that might make cost Owen J like $2,000 or $3,000 for support. So that funding flaw, that funding reform is something that it brings $500 million back to local property tax if that bill passes. So that's a big one to keep an eye on.